officer. So in after the examination, we have evaluation system also. Internal, external examiner conducts moderation. For even college exam, we call external moderator, and he does moderation if any there should not be any mistake happening in the paper. VIVA and evaluates projects and project reports of final year students. Group projects are allotted to students as a part of internal evaluation. Then another evaluation process reforms. The examination committee and unfair means committee deals with students' grievances as per University of Mumbai directives. Before the exams queries, like if anything change of subject, if any mistake happened in their form, we everything we rectify in the college itself. At the time of examination, question paper related queries are reported to invigilator, which is resolved by concerned subject expert. Any malpractice during examination is handled by our well-established unfair means committee. Post-examination queries also resolved by revaluation method. Rechecking are also resolved during examination. Then we have mentioned students' performance and learning outcomes. We follow following mechanism by the college to communicate the course outcomes. So every outcomes we have to reach to the students, we follow this method. The college displays program outcomes, program specific outcomes and course outcomes on the notice board. The syllabus of the respective program are shared with the students in the classroom and soft copies are uploaded on the college website. At the beginning of the academic year, during the orientation program, the students are informed about course and program outcomes. The respective subject teachers convey and sensitize the students regarding the course objectives, course outcomes, evaluation pattern, weightage and other course related information in the classroom. So this is how we conduct. We see to it that it reaches out to the students. The mentors discuss these with the mentees. Student performance and learning outcomes. Attainment of program and course outcomes. Preparation of monthly plan and records of teacher's diary facilitate the teacher and the students to focus on the predefined activities to achieve the outcome. Direct methods, class test, assignment, semester examination, seminars, laboratory assignment, practical, mini projects, class participation, role plays, group discussion, everything is decided in the beginning itself and it is conveyed to the students. Program outcome is assessed by conducting the semester and examination with passing marks for theory subject, for arts, commerce and science programs. So here we have displayed our result for the last 5 years. Actually, we are very much working hard to get a good result. As I told you in the beginning, students are coming from very low merits, but we have put all our efforts to bring up them to a level so that they get some good position in the society. So our percentages are mentioned here, 15, 16, 59%, 16, 17, 66%, 17, 18, 63%, 18, 90, 72%, 19, 20, 97%. So, resource mobilization for research. We receive grant received from government and non-governmental agencies for research projects, endowment shares in the institution. During the last 5 years, we have received, we have mentioned the data of last 5 years, it is 77,000. Number of teachers recognized as research guide in our college, they are 4. Number of departments having research project funded by government and non-government agencies during the last 5 years, here we have 1. We have arranged different during these 5 years. Every year we used to conduct seminars. We have tried our level best to conduct national seminars. after in coming years we will be planning for national international seminars also. Sometimes seminars are UGC approved, and in some are only we are paper based, that is participation in research papers. Number of research papers presented by our teachers, we have included this graph. So in 1920, we have from 1516, we have started from the per year, 1920. One bar is for research paper UGC journal, and one bar is for proceedings. Because now in the latest rule, we UGC which is included in KR list. So that is where we are now. We have started promoting this. Earlier we are based on only on the proceedings paper we were taking. So we have this data. Then in our college we have extension activities. We promote social work. Social network and students' engagement in extension activities constituting to good citizenship bearing high moral values. These are playing very important role in their making their career. Community service, holistic development of students to sensitize students NCC, NSS and DLT, that is distance lifelong learning. Committees plays pivotal role in this college. That is in I have highlighted some of the activities they are carrying out. Blood donation camp, women empowerment, cleanliness drive. They have conducted in various beaches in Bombay. Whenever social organization call our students, work some of these, they go there and they clean. Then NSS residential camp, every year we conduct a 7 days. They have to live there only day and night, and they conduct camp and nearby vicinity. Slum area, they teach them, they educated them the basic of life. Then we have awareness created about Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, awareness about the importance of safe water and safe soil, awareness about road safety. So many times this road traffic police, they come here, they take our students and they teach them how to love this road safety, and they spread this message to everyone. Traffic management during Ganesh Utsav, here it becomes a very difficult task. During 10 days Ganesh Utsav, every year it is a very big task for Mumbai police. So they take help of every college. So every college, some 40-50 students participated throughout 10 days, and they manage traffic and everything, and they learn also from that lot. Leadership quality and sense of social responsibilities promoted among the students. We have number of students participating in, I have mentioned here, extension activities, which just now I have mentioned here, in the every academic year, starting from 1516, so on. Number of activities 17, I will read fast. Number of students participating 740, 714, 1277, 935, 890, 427. We have included some pictures, so how they have carried out these social activities. The pictures are a little bit not here, but we have included here. So these pictures you can see. Extension activities. Again, more pictures, extension activities. Now I would like to bring here some physical facilities we are enabling our students to get. So again, built up area is 6,612 square meter, and CCTV camera we have installed 64. Computers right now we are having 102. Printer R12, scanner 5, barcoding printer 1, AY portable IR projectors 22, biometric machines 2, Wi-Fi router 8, furniture table available, air conditioners 21, auditorium 2, and elevators 3 we are having. 2 lifts in B wing and 1 lift in A wing. We have included some pictures to enable you to know the facilities that we are providing. Facilities for cultural activities, sports, games, indoor and outdoor. So we have included some picture here. These are the cultural. We have throughout the year our students participate in various cultural activities. Besides their studies, they participate in other colleges for competition also. They go for sports as well as cultural and other things also. Then our library, which is a learning resource of our college. Our library is automated using integrated library management system. All software modules run successfully, that is acquisition, cataloging, circulation, serial control, administration and open. These are provided in the library. Books are barcoded partially through iSLEEP software, issued and returned via software. Internal facility is internet.